Good evening. Firstly, have you met with the Prime Minister to discuss about the extension of the MCO? Second, one of the six criteria you mentioned about lifting the MCO is border control, first one. So we have seen how travel ban has actually effectively reduced the number of imported cases in the country. So do you think after the MCO is lifted, should we continue with a travel ban for maybe 1-2 months? What does the NOH think about this? And third, last one, why is it important to find out what are the virus strains A, B, C? Is it because of the treatment or the drugs that are needed to treat the virus? Thank you.
Okay, thank you very much. Yes, we did discuss. We have a meeting this morning. We have a meeting with the Prime Ministers. But more importantly is that we discussed the principle, the six criteria that we have. Certainly, we are still monitoring the situation closely. But the most important, I think the two, is the border control as well as the movement control. Lifting the MCO doesn't mean that we're going to lift the border control. In fact, we need to strengthen the border control. As you can see, that more than 180 countries are involved in positive, are involved in terms of they have cases. So border control must be strengthened. But what we are looking into, perhaps, we have not actually highlighted whether we will continue the MCO or not. But the criteria is basically we are looking into how we can advise the Prime Minister accordingly with regards to the local movement or the movement control. So we are based on the cases that we have, for example, the daily cases, looking to the RO, looking into the trend that we are seeing today. Today, I think for the last couple of days, we have seen double digit, that's good. What I would like to draw the attention here is today we have 71 cases. 19 cases are imported cases, so which means 52 are local transmission. Out of the 52 local transmission, 22 involving foreign workers from India, Bangladesh, as well as Pakistan. That is from Selangor mentioned. So we need to really look into the local transmission. When we ease the MCO and movement control, basically we need to look into the local transmission as well. So these are some of the indicators that we have. And I have mentioned earlier, we have six indicators. We need to compile all the six indicators before we can advise the Prime Minister accordingly to make a decision whether to continue the MCO or whether there will be a baby step exit strategy, or you call it soft landing for our exit strategy. So I think this is something that we will discuss in next few days.
So you haven't discussed this?
We discussed the principle, but now we need the facts and science basically behind it before we can table concrete evidence to show that whether we need to extend or not.